Hello students, now we discuss our three topics of uniform acceleration chapter for 11th class. So first we discuss velocity time relation, yani velocity of time to be future relation. These are the three important equations are first velocity time relation, second position time relations and position velocity relations. So these are the three equations. These are very important and these equations are always used in next classes. Okay, now we start. First, velocity time relation. So first we start an object start from A. It take time t1 or moving with a velocity v1. Now it reach to point C. Take time t2 and take velocity v2 with velocity v2. According to definition of acceleration, so what is acceleration? Acceleration is change in velocity by time taken. So this is our formula of acceleration. So how much velocity change from B to C? So it change V2 minus V1. So kya ho gaya? A point se velocity kitni change hui? V2. So B and C ke beech mein the acceleration is equal to V2 minus V1 by time. So this is T1 and this time is taken by T2. Then the time interval between B and C is T2 minus T1. Cross multiply, on cross multiply or solving this equation, A is equal to V2 minus V1 is equal to A T2 minus T1. We find the value of V2. V2 is equal to V1 plus A T2 minus T1. Now V2 is our final velocity and V2 is represented by V. So in our next classes, yeah, next chapter, V final velocity is represented by V. V1 is its initial velocity and it is represented by U plus A. The starting time is always taken for 0. Then starting time is T1 and taken as 0. After any time, then T2 is represented by T. There is a symbol. So V represent T2 by T. Then equation is T2 minus T minus 0. And V is equal to U plus AT. So this is our first equation. And this equation is known as V is equal to U plus AT and known as velocity time relation. This is velocity and this is time. So this is the relation between velocity time relation. So first equation our V is equal to U plus AT. Velocity time relation. This equation is known as velocity time relation. So in questions we can ask drive the derivation of velocity time relation. So you can cross it this article by like this and we write V equal to U plus AT. Our next equation is position time relation. Okay? The next equation position time relation. The position time relation, we say that an object cover distance x1 for at B point. B point to A point A is starting point and object cover x1 distance in time t1. So this is time t1. Then object cover distance x2. X2. The equation x2. Then the time taken t2. Now according to equation, so we use this formula. So we can know rough like we start this equation from here. So according to definition of average velocity. Average velocity. Average velocity is equal to change in displacement from B to C. The change in displacement x2, this is x1. The change in displacement is x2 minus x1. Change in time t2 minus t1. Now cross multiply, हम cross multiply करेंगे, the all cross multiply x2 minus x1 is equal to v average t2 minus t1. Average क्या हो गया? t2 minus t1. तो we can discuss earlier classes that the if initial and final velocity is given, initial velocity is v1, final velocity is v2, so we can find also average velocity by this formula. Average velocity can be find this formula v1 plus v2 by 2. हमने पहले वाली इक्वेशन में क्या था, यहां से यहां तक डिस्टेंस कितनी स्पीड से ट्रैवल की, v1 से फाइनल तक सीधा पॉइंट किया गया v2 से, देन दी एवरेज अगर दो वेलोसिटी गिवन है, स्ट्रेट लाइन मोशन है, स्ट्रेट लाइन मोशन है, तो हम उसके अंदर v1 plus v2 by 2 से डिवाइड कर देंगे. तो दिस इक्वेशन कैन बी पुट हियर, हमने यहां पुट किया x2 minus x1, x2 minus x1 is equal to v1 plus v2 by 2 and t2 minus t1. Now put the value of v2. So v2 की value हम यहाँ से find out करें. V2 की value, so that v2 is v2 minus v1 is equal to a t2 minus t1. And this is come out to be v2 equal to v1 plus a t2 minus t1. This equation put here. हम इस equation को यहाँ put कर देंगे, ठीक है? तो अब देखिए, हमने यहाँ equation put किया. Simple हम जो solve कर रहे हैं, mathematical जो steps हैं, वो हमें करने हैं. कोई ज्यादा कुछ चेंज नहीं है, सिर्फ मैथमेटिकल स्टेप्स पे हमें चलना है, सिर्फ वैल्यू हमें पुट करनी है, वैल्यू पुट करने के बाद वी कैन सॉल्व इट एज मैथमेटिकल स्टेप्स. तो देखिए x2 minus x1 is equal to v1 plus v1, v1 plus a t2 minus t1, ठीक है, and t2 minus t1. Okay? अब v1 और t1 क्या हो जाएगा? 2v1, तो x2 minus x1 2v1 multiply by this t2 minus t1 plus a t2 minus t1 का square. ठीक है, अब देखिए इसके नीचे टू और ये ऐसे इसको कर, ठीक है, अब इसको अलग अलग कर ले, डिनोमिनेटर को सेपरेट कर ले. तो सेपरेट करने के लिए आप इक्वेशन को यहां ले लीजिए, एक्स टू माइनस एक्स वन, एक्स टू माइनस एक्स वन इज इक्वल टू टू बी वन t2 minus t1 by 2 plus a t2 minus t1 by 2, or that is square. ठीक है, then x2 minus x1 is represented by s. v1 is initial velocity, 2 से 2 cancel हो गया, v1 is its initial velocity, we represent v1 is u, initial velocity is represented by u, t1 is our initial time, the initial time is represented by 0, this is represented by 0, and final time is represented by t, final time is represented by t. Put all these values in the equation, x2 minus x1 is s. So we write s, x2 minus x4 क्या लिखते हैं s, दिस इज आवर डिस्प्लेसमेंट, ठीक है ना। फाइनल डेस्टिनेशन सब्ट्रैक्ट करें तो हमारे पास क्या आएगा, डिस्प्लेसमेंट आ जाएगा। दिस इज आवर डिस्प्लेसमेंट, तो x की माइनस x इज रिप्रेजेंटेड एज s, इनिशियल वेलोसिटी रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय u, t1 0 t t minus 0 इट्स t, प्लस a by 2 एट t1 0 t2 is t एंड पावर इफ t स्क्वायर। तो दिस इज आवर नेक्स्ट इक्वेशन और नॉन एस पोजिशन, एस रिप्रेजेंट पोजिशन, टी रिप्रेजेंट टाइम, तो दिस इज द पोजिशन टाइम रिलेशन, ठीक है। तो वी कैन राइट दिस इक्वेशन हियर, एस इक्वल टू यू टी प्लस हाफ ए टी स्क्वेयर, एस इज इक्वल टू यू टी प्लस हाफ ए टी स्क्वेयर। तो दिस इक्वेशन राइट हियर, एस इज इक्वल टू ut plus half kt square. This is our second equation of position time relation. S represent position, u represent initial velocity, t is time, a represent acceleration. In above equation, v represent final velocity, u represent initial velocity, a represent acceleration, Average velocity is x2 minus x1 and t2 minus t1. So first we find displacement, change in time taken and average velocity. Now we find the x2 minus x1. So first we write x2 minus x1 is equal to v average t2 minus t1. Put the value of average velocity and we can say that average velocity is initial velocity plus final velocity divided by 2. So, x2 minus x1 is equal to v1 plus v2 by 2 and t2 minus t1. These are the same step of both these equations. These are the same steps. ये सारे के सारे same steps हैं। किसमें same step है? इसके अंदर हमारे दोनों position time relation में और position velocity relation में। तो ये दो यहाँ तक step same हैं। अब यहाँ पर step थोड़ा सा different हो जाएगा। With the help of first equation, हम first equation की help से हम t2 minus t1 निकालेंगे। तो first equation में हमने derivation जो किया था, उस derivation से start करते हैं। Derivation हमने किया ना, acceleration is equal to change in velocity by time taken, t2 minus t1. Then t2 minus t1 is equal to v2 minus t1 by a. So put the value of here t2 minus t1 की value अब इस equation में put कर देंगे, अब put the value in this equation. तो x2 minus x1, x2 minus x1 is equal to v1 plus v2 by 2 and value of t2 minus t1 is equal to v2 minus v1 by a. This is the equation comes from the first में जो हमने solve किया था, उसकी solve किया था, तो वहां पर हमने definition लिखी थी। acceleration क्या होता है, change in velocity by time taken, t2 minus t1 is equal to v2 minus v1 by a. तो value put करते हैं हम यहाँ पर v2 minus v1 by a. This is the positive, both are positive, दोनों वैल्यू पॉजिटिव, तो आगे पीछे लिख सकते हैं, ठीक है ना। तो हमने इसको x2 minus x1 को हमने लिख दिया v2 plus v1 by 2 and v2 minus v1 by a. So this is the formula of A plus B, A minus B. So it's come out to be x2 minus x1 is equal to b2 square minus b1 square by 2a. ठीक है? Now we put the value x2 minus x1. X2 minus x1 is represented by s. Final velocity is represented by v. Initial velocity is represented by u and 2a. Now we cross multiply. This equation is 2as is equal to v square minus u square. This is our third equation. Distance, velocity. Position, velocity. This is our position velocity relation. So we write the position velocity relation is 2as is equal to v square minus u square. So this is our third equation. So हमने first equation velocity time relation, second position time relation, third position velocity relation. V is equal to u plus a t. This is the relation of velocity and time. Position into position and the time. Position and the velocity. So these are the three relations of uniform acceleration equation. So तीन relations आते हैं हमारे इस equations के. ठीक है? तो आपको ये equation learn करना है इनको और ये numericals के लिए बहुत important है और इनके derivations. Derivation कैसे formula बने? इनको भी आपको learn करना है. इसके बाद कुछ ग्राफ है और फिर क्या है इसके बाद हम इनको ग्राफिकल मेथड से भी इक्वेशंस को निकालेंगे. ठीक है? तो आज के लिए बस ऑल ऑफ थैंक यू.